I had to do some drywall repair on this wall. I had some water pipes break a while back, and today was the day that I decided to open the wall up and start repairing the drywall. I've always wanted to play with audio exciters. Well, I have played with audio exciters before in other small projects. There's a lot of great projects that I found on YouTube. Check the links in the description below to some of these other projects that I have found that are very informative and really lit the fire of interest for me to wanting to do this, put audio exciters inside drywall, behind drywall, inside a wall. Unfortunately, of all the great videos that I have found on YouTube where audio exciters are used in audio projects, unfortunately, none that I could find use audio exciters in drywall or on drywall or use drywall as the speaker membrane. For those of you who don't know, an audio exciter is a very simple device that you put onto any surface. You just stick it with the 3M sticky tape. You just stick it to any surface, a cardboard box, a glass window, and you power it like a speaker. You put a positive and negative speaker wire to it, and this will vibrate the surface, turning the surface into a speaker. So in there lies the idea, hey, couldn't we put it behind drywall and turn the wall into a speaker? And none of the videos I found really answered that question, but it certainly raises the question. So I tore open the wall with the plan to do two things with this wall open. This wall is as open as I need it to be in order to fix the drywall damage that I had. And what you're looking at, the inside of the wall, the dark drywall you're seeing right there, is the inside of the wall from the bathroom. On the other side of that wall is a bathroom. And I have stuck four of these audio exciters to the back side of the wall. If you've seen my previous video about this subject, you remember me talking about me putting four of this model inside the bathroom and eight of this model in the same wall in the dining room side. I changed my mind. As I worked through this project and realized that I had eight of these and only four of these, that's why, because I only had four and I was only gonna commit four to the bathroom, is why I decided to use these four, or why I planned to use these four inside the bathroom. However, as identical as these units are, they're both one of Parts Express's top-end audio exciters, more expensive audio exciters, which is to say they're not expensive at all. I think these are $22, $24 each. And as they're pricier models, they're remarkably affordable. However, as similar as they are, they both have 32 millimeter voice coils. They both are 4-ohm models, and they both can handle 40 watts. I suspect, electrically speaking, they are essentially the same, probably the same magnet structure, probably the same voice coil inside. The only real difference, as you can see, is the mounting. This one mounts using plastic spider arms and sticky foam tape, along with the center 3M tape on the voice coil itself. This, you'll see that the spider arms are metal, and they're internalized inside the housing, and the 3M sticky tape on the voice coil is much larger. My perception is that this is the better model. So I wanted to save what I perceive to be the better of the two models for the dining room side of that wall, because that's where most of my casual listening is going to be, entertaining guests and what have you in the dining room. So I have saved four of these for the dining room side of this wall, and I put four of the eight inside the bathroom. You can see some speaker wire dangling. That's the speaker wire that goes to these four audio exciters. I have two per channel. They're run in series per channel. So being 4 ohms, I have an 8 ohm load, which makes it very easy to drive for a regular household amplifier. I did, however, include one of these on the positive terminal of each speaker set. And this is what Parts Express calls a speaker protector. I casually call them a bass blocker, because that's essentially what they do. They block the bass. Of all the audio exciter projects I have found on YouTube, everyone who has done a project comes to two conclusions. A, it sounds unexpectedly remarkable, and B, it does lack bass. As great as it sounds, it does lack bass. And I fully expect that. And I fully expect that inside this wall, because I'm asking these audio exciters to excite or move drywall, which is very heavy. It's bolted down to the wooden studs, and I didn't expect a lot of movement out of it. The audio exciters, you can't really see them because they're tucked up behind this line. So you can't really see them, but they are essentially just stuck to the inside of that wall. They're just sticky tape, stick them in place. I soldered all my connections to make them a forever connection because I'm never going back in this wall. Well, here's the punchline. Even in drywall, it sounds unexpectedly amazing. I am blown away. I only use 2 per channel on the bathroom side. Now, as you know, I'm going to be using 4 per channel in the same wall on the dining room side. And I was concerned that I'd be burning money just mounting 4 of these audio exciters on the bathroom side, and it wouldn't be enough to excite the drywall. It's enough. It sounds remarkable. Yes, it lacks bass. It absolutely lacks bass. But no, it's not noticeable. It's not like it's absolutely absent. In a small room like the bathroom, I'm gonna say it's acceptable. You don't need the bass. And here's the thing. For anyone who doesn't know that that's where the sound is coming from vibrating drywall, from the exciters hidden behind the drywall, you wouldn't know it. It's not like it's a substandard sound. And here, let me say this much. I've never been a fan of the sound quality of smart speakers or Bluetooth speakers. I like good quality sound from my stereo. And unfortunately, the world has moved towards smart speakers. And make no mistake, I'm a big believer in smart speakers. I myself have a lot of the Amazon smart speaker systems in my house, and I use them all the time. But make no mistake, most smart speakers don't sound good. They sound acceptable. They sound good enough for what you ask them to do. But they are by far anything close to hi-fi or critical listening. And I'm not suggesting that's what this is. This is not a critical listening reference type speaker. But compare it to today's trend that people are listening to their music. Their primary music listening is done on a smart speaker or a Bluetooth speaker. I'm going to be the first to say it. This smokes it. There is no smart speaker in my house. And I have them all of the Amazon. I have the big ball, I have the little ball, I have the screens. None of them come anywhere close to the sound quality of this. You want to talk about something lacking bass? A smart speaker that fits in your hand lacks bass, let's be honest. So to be critical and say this lacks bass, by that standard, it doesn't. This sounds amazing. Let me show you. Unfortunately, I'm going to play some sounds, and I'm going to enjoy it, but of course you're listening to it on your computer and you're not going to get the real effect, but let me show you. That's my iPad, and I'm going to send this iPad sound to the wall, the bathroom side. Here it comes. It's coming. It's half volume. That's it. It's two of these per channel. That's royalty-free music, by the way. That's it. Two of these per channel stuck to that drywall, shaking the drywall as if it were shaking a speaker cone, is all that's going on here with dramatic fashion. And if you can, I'm actually glad that when I hit play, it played it from the iPad. So you could compare the difference, because an iPad is going to sound more similar to a smart speaker or a Bluetooth speaker than that wall does. There is a remarkable and dramatic difference. I have in-wall speakers. I'm looking at them now just in my other room. I have in-wall speakers as my main TV listening speakers, and they sound great. I'm a big believer in high-quality in-wall speakers, and I've had them for years, and I'm going to continue using in-wall speakers. But I made a promise to myself when I finished this project, the bathroom side, just before I shot this video, I made a promise to myself, every time for the rest of my life where I have no choice but to open up a wall, I have no plans to open up walls, I'm not a drywaller, I'm not a home renovation guy, but unfortunately life has it where sometimes you have to open up a wall. There is no doubt in my mind, every time I open up a drywall, I am mounting audio exciters inside that wall so I can do this everywhere. This is remarkable. Only two audio exciters per channel. When I finish this wall, I'll do another follow-up video for you, because I'm going to put four audio exciters per channel on this side of the wall. Of course, they're gonna be hidden on the inside of the wall, but they'll be on the inside of this side of the, on the dining room side of the wall. And I will be using bass blockers for those as well, but in this room, because it is a bigger space, I am going to have a subwoofer installed as well. So if this is at all an indicator of how that's gonna sound, let's be honest, I'd be thrilled if it sounded like that. That's my bathroom sound. You're hearing that because, of course, the wall is open. That's the bathroom side of the wall making that noise. This is outstanding. It's not for everybody. It takes some skill. You have to be able to wire it yourself. You have to be able to solder it. You certainly want to be able to understand series parallel. It's nothing too complicated, nothing too difficult. But if you have reason to open up your drywall, if you're renovating or building a new home, what a remarkably inexpensive way to have stellar sound inside your home that has to have the thumbs up from anybody. They sound great in every way. I'll put a few links in the description below to the products that I've used. To give you an opportunity. If you like this project, if you want to follow this and see my follow-up videos, subscribe to this channel, hit the thumbs up button, and that way you'll get a notification when I do finish this wall and do a final review of the finished product. Highly recommended. Sorry, folks, I just wanted to add two more things. Is I screwed up when I said hit the thumbs up button to get notifications on more videos following this project, is you need to hit the bell icon in order to get notifications for follow-up projects. And while I got you, I just wanted to give you a close-up view of the inside of that wall, looking up at those exciters mounted inside. That's it. You just literally stick them to the drywall. It's really quite simple. And a lot of fun with great results. See you next time.